All right, Alberta. You can tell me synthetic division, long division, or you can't pick the answer because you do at the end. So you can pick one.
Synthetic.
All right. What goes on the outside?
One.
And what goes on top there? Tell me how to do it.
You multiply, and then you drop down to 1. You multiply 1 by 1, get 1. You subtract it, you get 5.
Question. Should you be subtracting or adding? Thumbs up, thumbs down, class? Alberto, what do we mean to do? Okay, now add. Okay. Yeah. Add it. So what do you get?
Five.
Thank you, Alberto.
Multiply -5 by 1, you get -5. You subtract, you get -43. And then you get -43. Multiply.
Raise your hand if you got -64. Alright. Jeremiah. You get to do long division. Jeremiah, what am I going to write here? And I'm just going to write this for you. Jeremiah, how many times does x go into x to the fourth?
X. I mean, 2.
Multiply.
-1x
to the 7. Good. Keep going. So now we're going to subtract them.
And then you get 7x to the third.
7x to the third is correct.
And you bring down the negative 10.
How many times is x going to 7x cubed?
That's 7x squared. And then we put 7x squared plus 7x. I mean 7x cubed plus 7x squared.
Positive or minus?
Minus.
Add or subtract? Okay. Negative 5. Now what, Jeremiah?
Then you bring down the -38.
Jeremiah, how many times is x going to -5?
-5x.
Go ahead and multiply. Remember, you have synthetic division over there to help you. And how many times is x going to
-43?
So if I multiply, what do you get? -43, that's +43 is correct. subtract those, and what do you get? Negative
64.
Negative 64. That's why they call it long division. All right, Joe, finish this up. Is this a factor? No. No what? Because what? That'd be sufficient.